Turnaround for the auto industry. Is it here? The head of the biggest auto dealer in the country says you better bet on it. Mike Jackson, CEO of AutoNation, joins us now. So, Mike, we turn the corner?
Absolutely, Poppy. If you look at our first quarter performance, it is a revenue story. For every category in every segment, we see an improvement in revenue totaling for the company a full 19%. And if you just look at new vehicle sales, revenue is up 24%. We have a 19% improvement in unit volume, but we also have higher content with the average sale price going up $1,000. For the industry, there's actually lower incentives than a year ago. And you put that all together with improving front-end margins for both us and I'm sure for the manufacturer. That means it's a real, genuine recovery.
You know, you've got more than 200 dealerships across the country. What are the salesmen and women on the floor telling you? What are customers telling them? Why are they willing to spend now?
Here is the irony that I've been talking about for over a year. We're comparing to the first quarter of 2008, when those customers were actually there, but we had absolutely no credit for them. We couldn't get them financed. So the previous year's numbers are a grotesque distortion caused by the financial crisis. And credit has very much improved and normalized from a year ago. So it's this healing of credit that has made the biggest difference from a year ago. Now, if you combine that with the downward spiral in housing is over, the extreme unemployment situation is changing, employment is stabilized, people feel more confident about their jobs. And in the premium luxury segment, of course, the equity markets and the bond markets are so much better than a year ago. The industry is on its way to selling an 11.5 million units this year. It's still a long journey back to 16 million, but the fact that we have this kind of turnaround on revenue across the board means the recovery is the real deal.
You know, looking at Florida, where you guys sell about 30% of your vehicles, huge success story there, right? I mean, why? Why the Sunshine State?
Well, we have always maintained that we liked our footprint, despite the fact that California, Nevada, Arizona, and Florida were the ground zero for this economic meltdown. But we said, you know, human nature is not going to change. These states have thousands of miles of coastline and beautiful sunshine, and ultimately they will recover. Now, what's happened in Florida is we see stability around housing. Unit level sales have increased. The pricing is stable, has not recovered yet. And an employment situation has stabilized. And that gives people the confidence to go out and spend $30,000 on a vehicle. And when they come in now, we can arrange the financing for them.
Looking at Toyota, that's a big question, Mike. I mean, I know your Toyota sales were up significantly in the first quarter, but is the buyer really coming back to Toyota in a meaningful way?
The buyer really never left. We saw the fundamental confidence and trust of the Toyota customers remained through the entire crisis. So they improved their incentive package, and the customers responded to it overwhelmingly. And in March, our Toyota sales were up 38%, you know, an astounding figure.
I mean, we know Ford has been riding on a high wave for a while now, but what about especially GM and Chrysler? How are they selling at this point? What are customers saying about the domestic automakers that are, you know, now trying to repay the bailouts that they got from taxpayers?
No question, Ford accrued a dramatic brand equity by not taking a government bailout, and it's been a challenge for General Motors and Chrysler. The fact that General Motors is repaying all the loans ahead of schedule is significant. And you combine that with the fact that they have excellent products, bodes well for General Motors. Chrysler has the biggest challenge in that their product cadence was the most disrupted by the events of the downward spiral and by the bankruptcy, and their new products really begin to come later this year. So Chrysler has the tougher road to go. This has been a transformational period for the domestics. Their old business model is gone. It's about sustainability and profitability. They have matched the Japanese on quality. The perception gap is closing rapidly. So I think we're in a new era where this 20-year transfer of share from the domestics to the Japanese is ending.